Wow, we still got the Christmas music rocking, AJ. So maybe you've taken down your Christmas tree, maybe you have not, but once it is gone, there's often a hole left, right? Well, our good friend AJ Petini is here to show us some ways to kind of fill that space back up. It becomes very vacant. It's kind of depressing.
It is a little bit. Houseplants are so easy to take care of.
Yes.
And they do, especially when we're cooped up in the wintertime,
yeah.
They do so much to benefit us. You know, it's just nice to have them around. They also do a lot to clean the air. So
oh.
That's a really important benefit, that it takes a lot of the chemicals, a lot of the pollutants out of the air. It helps really filter the air.
Can you have too much, though, in your house?
That's a personal thing. I don't think you can have too much. I mean, it's like too much oxygen. So, you know, you can't have too much oxygen.
Yeah, that's very true.
But, you know, it just depends on what you want and what you want to take care of. But, you know, they're great for the office, great to give as a little gift.
Yeah.
But really just nice to have around. And they're really easy to take care of. The number one rule is just don't overwater. That's
yes.
really the biggest thing. You know, if you want to get a moisture meter, those are really effective. And just wait for the plants to go dry. Like, for example, there's a ponytail palm on the end over here.
I love this one.
And so they're beautiful. Actually, I was talking to Stacy. She's had hers for 15 years.
Stacy Fry's had
yeah.
a ponytail? Oh,
yeah.
My goodness.
Who knew? So, so she's had it for such a long time. They don't take a lot of water. They love high light. But, you know, a lot of these plants, just don't need to overwater them, and
they'll
be great to go all the way
through.
Now,
see, there's not a lot of sunshine, really, you know, in Northeast Ohio. So how do we do that? Do we need to keep them close to the windows to soak up that?
So you want to pull them, for the most part, you want to pull a lot of them away from the window.
Oh.
Some that really love a lot of sun, the problem is the window magnifies. So even just a foot or two away from the window, and you'll be in good shape. But if there's not a lot of light, there's great plants. This is a peace lily.
That one's shiny.
Yeah, well, we goose it up a little bit. And then that's a Sansevieria right next to you, this tall, skinny guy.
Okay.
And so those
that's
guys, you can actually put those in a dark bathroom or in a closet, and they'll be just fine.
Really?
So these
that
do well
I can
in
do.
Really, really low
Less
light.
Less you have to take care of, the more my plants turn out.
Yeah, and so you just, you know, that's so easy to do. And then there's some really pretty ones. This is a citrus, and these
smell.
Someone
smells good. Is that that one?
These smell amazing, and you get a true lemon on there. So there's a few of them. I think there's like six or seven. There's one little guy right here.
Stop
so,
that! Really?
Yeah. And you can pick them. You can eat them.
Oh
for
my
sure.
goodness!
Yeah.
Now it's a little like honeysuckle. Can you actually eat that?
You can.
No?
You can eat the fruit. You don't want to eat
the
flower. So let the flower just bloom. So, but when the fruit's mature, you'll get a legitimate lemon, and you can use it in salads or lemonade or whatever else you want to use.
Wow.
And there's different. There's oranges, there's grapefruits, there's all different kinds. And this is actually a really fun one, especially with kids. You can turn this into a little project. So this is a spider plant, and it's got all these little pups, and this is actually one of the most effective plants for cleaning the air. So
really? Why is that?
It just, the way it you want to look at how much foliar surface area it has.
Okay.
Same thing with peace lily, same thing with the fiddle leaf, Sansevieria. Actually, all these are really good rubber plants. But what makes these really fun is I just pulled this little pup off. You can actually take this, plant it in soil, and you've got new spider plants.
Really?
And so if you've got
and they tend to just keep growing and growing,
oh, yeah,
right?
Yeah. They grow like weeds, and so they're really easy to start. So it's something that really fun. So as you're looking at them, you know, a lot of times they come in pots that really aren't all that special.
Mm-hmm.
There's a few different things that you can do. So this is one, so just a drop in. So you want to make sure that you pay attention. So this is a pot with, trying to figure out which one, there we go. So this is a pot without a hole. So that's something that you want to be really aware of, because the water will sit in the bottom.
Sure,
so this is a pot with a hole. So that's something that, it's got a saucer that's attached to it, so you want to make sure you're aware
this
of that, but
nice.
It's really nice. But they're both great for both things. So this is just a rubber plant, and this just, it's easy peasy. So put a few rocks just on top, which is, it's just a nice way to dress it up.
Yeah.
You know, you're not showing the soil and it gets dusty and kind of
that. Right.
So it's just a nice way, and it's easy.
And that's it.
And then boom, yeah. And it's just a great way if you want to give a gift, if you want to have it in the house or your office.
That's pretty, that's
nice. It's just poof and easy. And then if you've got one that you want to drop in, so this is just a little ivy plant. This isn't one you want to, if your plants need transplanting, this is not one you want to be transplanting, but I'm just dropping this in soil and all.
Okay.
And so we're just going to pop this guy in and then just add a little bit of stone right around the top. Now, as I said, there's no hole in the bottom of this plant, in the bottom of this pot. So if you do this and you've got a pot with no hole, you really want to be careful with how much water you're putting in there. So
okay.
They like to run dry as it goes, and then so just make sure they're
extra
aware.
And then I love
aware.
The spray. I'm very familiar
yes.
with sprays because I have a lot of fake greenery in my house, but this is kind of
yeah. So this is an
real.
Oil-based.
It's this real
is,
things.
This is an aerosol, and
that's
there's also
so
some
pretty.
That are organic that are just regular pumps. So you know, just I know, right? So a little Aquanet.
Yeah.
So don't worry about a thing.
Nice.
So. Anyway, but it just kind of dresses it up and cleans it up, and so just easy.
You make us feel happier in the month of January, you know?
It's easy.
Go visit all of AJ's stores. He always has fun stuff going on. AJ, thank you.
Thank you
so much. It's been fun. All right.